talking about money, honey, status, power, and fame. But I'm here to tell you about that name. And if you haven't heard it yet, then your whole world about to change. I'm talking about love. Talking about freedom. Talking about the one you can depend on when you need them. I'm talking about mercy. Grace and forgiveness. Talking about good God Almighty, you need to hear this.
Praise the Lord. Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah this morning, because this is the day that the Lord has made. I will rejoice and be glad in it. Hallelujah. King David said something like this. I was glad when they said unto me, let us go into the house of the Lord. Are you excited this morning, Galilee? In spite of the situation and conditions we are going through, we are still able to come into the house of the Lord and give his name the praise, the honor, and the glory. Hallelujah to his name. Bless the name of the Lord. Our call today is we are building by faith, expanding for the future through prayer, purpose, and provision. Hallelujah. Let us repeat after me the reading of Psalms 100. Make a joyful noise unto the Lord, all ye lands. Serve the Lord with gladness. Come before his presence with singing. Know ye that the Lord, he is God. It is he that hath made us, and not we ourselves. We are his people, and the sheep of his pasture. Enter into his gates with thanksgiving, and into his courts with praise. Be thankful unto him, and bless his name. For the Lord is good, his mercy is everlasting, and his truth endureth to all generations. If you believe that this morning, let's give God a hand clap of praise. Hallelujah, because he is worthy to be praised from the rising of the sun unto the going down of the same. Hallelujah, his name is to be praised. Bless the name of the Lord. Let us prepare our hearts and our minds to pray. Gracious Heavenly Father, we thank you for this another day, God, that you have allowed us to see. And God, because you woke us up this morning with breath in our bodies, we are giving your name the glory, the honor, and the praise. We thank you, Lord, for this place, Lord, that we can come to worship. God, we pray today, God, that your spirit will move throughout the atmosphere. Lord, that your presence will be known, God, in all situations and conditions. We thank you today, God, for being merciful to us and forgiving us of our sins. We pray even right now, God, even as, God, we go forth into this day, God, that we will praise you, Lord, like we know you. We thank you today, God, for just, God, providing for us, Lord, roof over our head, clothes on our back, food in our refrigerator and our cabinets. We pray today, God, that you will bless us, God, through this service. Bless, Lord, those that are apart, Lord. We ask that you would get the glory in all that we do. It is in Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Bless the name of the Lord. He is worthy this morning. Hallelujah, God. He is worthy to be praised. Bless the name of this Lord. Throughout this service, you will text to 474747 to join Galilee or to request prayer. Again, the text is 474747. Now, let's turn it over to the worship leader. Let's give God some praise. Hallelujah. Glory to his name.
Thank you, God. Hallelujah, God. Hallelujah. Come on and keep on giving God some praise. Come on and keep God giving God that praise. Because he's so wonderful. He's so worthy. He's worthy of our praise. He's worthy of all our honor. And we serve a great and powerful God. And he has a name that's above every name. Here on the earth and in heaven. And we're going to lift up that great name. If you know the song, can you help us sing? Here we go, y'all. Hey, we love. explain that happens when we proclaim your great name. Come on and help me sing. Say, we love to call your heart. It's something
we cannot explain
that happens. I want to sing that again. Can we sing that again? Hey, say, say, we love to call on your name.
It's something
that we, that happens when we, let's go, y'all, let's take it up. This morning, there's power in the name of Jesus. There's power in your name. Come on and help me say,
there is power in the name of Jesus.
There's power.
Things change when we call you.
Hey, yeah. shall bow, every tongue confess. Say, when I call your name, when I call your name. Say, when I call your name, when I call your name. Say, when I call your name, when I call on the name of Jesus. Oh, when I call on you, Jesus. Say, when I call your name, yeah, yeah. Say, when I call your name, yeah, yeah. Say, when I call your name. I'm trying to let it go, but I can't help but call on the name of Jesus. Hey, I wanna call your name, oh, cancer is removed when I call your name, oh, God. Oh, I get my healing when I call on the name of Jesus. Oh, when I call on the name of Jesus. Hey, oh, the tumor is removed, oh, God. Hey, when I call on the name of Jesus, yeah. Hey, every knee shall bow, every tongue confess, your Lord. Hey, the blood still works, yeah, yeah. Say when I call, hey, say when I call your name, oh God. Hey, say when I call your name, yeah, yeah, yeah. Say when I call your name, say when I call your name, hey. Worship Him. Go on and worship Christ our Lord. Go on and worship Christ our Lord. Oh Lord, you're good. Oh Lord, you're good. Yeah. Hallelujah. 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 Hey. Hallelujah when we call your name. Hallelujah when we call your name. Hallelujah. Say when I call your name. Oh Lord, when I call your name. Hey, when I call your name, oh God. When I call on the name of Jesus, oh, when I call your name. The name of Jesus breaks every chain, oh God. Oh, oh, oh. Come on and worship with us at home. Oh Lord, we want to call on your name. Hey, when I call on the name of Jesus, oh, I said the cancer will be moved. No more growth in your body, the cancer will be moved. Yeah. All you gotta do is open your mouth and call on the name of Jesus. All you gotta do is open up your mouth and call on the name of Jesus. I know we're in a pandemic, y'all, but I gotta call on the name of Jesus, yeah. Hey, that's what He's asking for us to do, is call on Him. Hey, we thought that we could do it on our own, but He said, call on me. That's the only way that we can get out of this thing, is if we call on Him, yeah. Hey, I feel my breakthrough when I call. Hey, I feel my breakthrough when I call. Hey, I feel my breakthrough when I call. There's somebody at home dealing with something that you can't think, that you think you can't shake, but all you gotta do is call on the name. Hey, when I call on the name, yeah, when I call on the name of Jesus. Hey, when I call your name, this is the last time, I promise y'all. Hey, when I call your name, oh, come on and clap your hands and give God the glory. Hallelujah.
All y'all today.
Amen.
I know it's been over a year that I've seen some of you all, so I'm glad to see you today. But we're here to talk about one thing, and that's Pastor's 21st pastoral anniversary. Are we excited about that?
Yes.
Yes.
We sure are. And I'm so glad that we're here together to celebrate.
And that celebration begins today at 9 a.m. with our kickoff service with Pastor Remus Wright from the Fountain of Praise Church in Houston, Texas.
All right.
Now, we all know Pastor Wright has celebrated with us a lot over the past 21 years. And it is truly a blessing to be able to have him with us today, even virtually. Aline, tell them what else we got going on.
Well, on Wednesday, April the 21st at 7 p.m., we'd be blessed to have Reverend Nicholas Young of the First Baptist Church of Guilford in Columbia, Maryland.
That's going to be a great service. Yeah. But we'll also have, on April 23rd, Bishop Hortense Vaughn.
My hallelujah belongs to you. Oh, my hallelujah belongs to you. The next part I really love, it says this. You deserve it.
Oh, I just love that song. It's going to be so amazing to see him perform even virtually.
Then our grand finale is on Sunday, April 25th at 10 a.m. with our first ever drive-in pastoral worship service.
All right.
Wow, that's going to be so amazing.
Live preaching by Pastor Major Stewart of Greater Mount Sinai Baptist Church coming from Charlotte, North Carolina. He is a birth familiar face. You've seen him before, right, y'all?
Yeah.
We'll also have live singing featuring our very own Shemaiah Praise Team.
All right.
And we will continue to practice social distancing as everyone will remain in their car.
Okay. And we're also going to have some very special presentations that will be done. We will also have a special treat and gift for everyone who attends on Sunday morning. Everyone.
So make sure you pick up your placard from the church office on Tuesday, Wednesday, Thursday between the hours of 11 a.m. and 3 p.m.
Okay, and if they don't get a placard, then you can still participate in the services by watching, as you always have been, on our live streaming sites.
You know, over the past 21 years, Pastor McGriff has been there for all of us.
Yes.
During the high times in our lives and even the low times in our lives. He's celebrated with us during our achievements, and he has encouraged and supported us even during times of illness and grief.
That's so true, Sister Doctor. And you know, this is a great opportunity for all of us to get an opportunity to say thank you to Pastor McGriff. So if you can't make it to the service, we ask that you drop by, drop off a card, a note, or some form of appreciation to him to show that you care about him and that you love him.
Your gift can be on behalf of yourself, your family, or your ministry.
No gift is too large or too small. Just a card to show that you care.
Well, is there anything else to say?
Yes! Happy 21st Pastoral Anniversary!
You're amazing. You cause the sun and moon to shine. I'm so glad you're.
Here we go.
Thank you, Jesus. We're
This is the day that the Lord has made. Let us all rejoice and be glad in it. Greetings, Galilee family, and all of those that are watching by way of stream, watching today this live broadcast. We thank you, each and every one. I'm Dr. Remus Wright, the pastor of the Fountain of Praise Church here in Houston, Texas, and it is my distinct privilege and honor to be a part of this worship service today. Because today we honor a great man and woman of God, two people that are very near and dear to my heart, and Reverend Dr. Lloyd T. McGriff, Sister Monica McGriff. And I want you all to know, Galilee, that Monica and Lloyd are more than just colleagues in the gospel, but they are very dear and close friends. As a matter of fact, my wife Mia and I talk about them all the time. We've had the privilege of traveling together. We've had the privilege of eating together. We've had the privilege of praying together. I mean, all of those things that make for special relationships and friendships, we found them in Dr. Lloyd T. and Sister Monica. And I want them to know today, Lloyd, Monica, we're praying God's richest blessings on you guys. And after 21 years of doing wonderful ministry, we believe that God's going to even a larger territory all the more. We believe that greater things are about to happen. Greater victories are about to be seen. Greater expansion is about to be felt. And the Galilee Baptist Church family is going to see some monumental things through your leadership. Bless each and every one of you. It's our joy to be here. And you know, I'm sorry that I could not be there in person, because after 21 years, I feel like I've been a part of this for half of those 21. And it saddens me that I can't be there in person, but certainly we are with you in spirit and in love. And we thank God for the privilege and the honor of addressing this wonderful congregation once again. Today in the Word of God, found in the book of Psalms, the 124th division, this is what God's Word says to us. It says, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, so let all of Israel now say, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, when men rose up against us, then they would have swallowed us alive when their wrath was kindled against us. Then the waters would have overwhelmed us. The stream would have gone over our soul. Then the swollen waters would have gone over our soul. Blessed be the Lord who has not given us as prey to their teeth. Our souls has escaped as a bird from the snare of the fowlers. Snare is broken and we have escaped. Listen to verse 8 now. Our help is in the name of the Lord who has made heaven and earth. Our help is in the name of the Lord who has made heaven and earth. Today on this 21st anniversary celebration, I want to talk to you from the thought, our ultimate help. Our ultimate help. If you'll pray with me now. Gracious God and Father, you've been our help in times past. You are our hope in ages to come. We bless you and praise you and magnify you today. We worship and adore you, oh God, because you are a good God. You're kind and a comforting God. We bless you for 21 years of pastoral leadership at Galilee by the Reverend Dr. Lloyd T. McGriff. We thank you that you have made him the set man of this house, and you're using him in a magnificent way to continue to lift up the spirit of your people. I pray that you might continue to bless he and his wife Monica as they lead your people, oh God. Crown their heads with wisdom and knowledge. Cover them with your divine protection. Let your blood overshadow them, oh God. Put a, Lord God, an unction in his mouth, Lord God, and a confidence in his spirit as he speaks your word. I pray, Lord God, that you might continue, Lord God, to help them work as a team to do great things right there in Washington, D.C. Oh God, I pray that you might continue in Suitland, Maryland, Lord God, to do mighty and miraculous things in their ministry and in their lives. Now, Lord God, we pray today that you might help us to preach your word. Send your anointing, oh God, that anointing that makes preaching easy That anointing that destroys every yoke. That anointing that lifts up bowed down heads and Father, gives strength and power to troubled lives. We pray today that you'll breathe upon these words and make them thine. Use me, Lord God, in your service to the end that your name might be glorified, magnified, and praised. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen and amen. Once again, I want to talk today from the subject, our ultimate help. This psalm represents one of the 15 Jewish pilgrim songs that they sang as they ascended up into the house of worship. As a matter of fact, if you look at the superscription in your Bible, they're entitled the Songs of Ascents. And they say this because many theologians argue that as the Jewish people gathered into the city of Jerusalem and into the temple and their synagogue, that as they ascended into that place, at each of the steps going into the temple, they would stop and sing another song. They would sing songs of recovery. They would sing songs of deliverance. They would sing songs of victory. They would sing songs of worship and of praise. And this particular psalm is the fifth of these 15 songs. And they sang this near the church doors. And I want you, as you think about it, notice the mindset of these Jewish worshipers. They sing with unadulterated praise and unapologetic worship as they say, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side, where would we be? I love this because it's an exciting moment of reflection and remembrance of the God's continual deliverance in times of distress. It is a psalm that talks about God's favor and blessings that has been poured out upon his people. What a story they had to tell. And what a story, Pastor McGriff, we have to tell today. I'm sure that when you and Monica reflect over these 21 years, over the labor that you've given to the kingdom of God, I'm sure there's so many things that you can reflect and talk about as it relates to God's dealings with you. Think about the way God has blessed you to not only raise your children, but to raise up a ministry that went from a small nucleus of people to a large group of worshipers Sunday after Sunday. Think about the way that although the pandemic has hit us and has hurt many people, has caused a crippling effect in many instances with the people of God, you're still pushing forward and persevering. It's because God is with you and because God has been watching out over you. So it was with these Jewish pilgrims as they enter into their temple and think about all the marvelous things that God has done. In this psalm, there are many things that you will find, but things that I really want to emphasize today is, first of all, I want you to see the answer to their past. The answer to their past. See, the Lord was on their side as they went back and they regurgitated all of the wonderful things that God had done. They recognized that they had a selective Savior. Yes, a selective Savior. By that, I mean, they looked at what we look at today. He didn't have to do it, but he did. Oh no, he didn't have to bless them. He didn't have to recover them. He didn't have to restore, renew them, but he did. He was and is a selective Savior. Yes, David looks back and sees the controversial course of his past and recognizes that it would have been impossible to navigate through without the help of the Lord. I mean, think about it as a pastor, as a leader. How there were many times that you were troubled because you didn't know exactly what decisions to make. And yet each and every time God would come through with the answer that was needed. Look at how God has blessed us to do what we do. But then Galilee congregation, look at how God has blessed you in many of the instances of your past. Wouldn't you say with me readily that he is a selective savior? I mean, think about it. In your family, how many people could he have saved before he saved you? How many people could he have delivered before he delivered you? How many people could he have given victory to before he gave victory to you? And yet God looked over many mothers and fathers and sisters and brothers and sons and daughters and called your name. He is a selective savior. Out of the muck and the mire of sin, out of unhealthy relationships, out of troubled past, God has over and over again proven to us that he is a selective savior. I mean, it would be impossible to even imagine life without the help of God. See, some of you might not remember his power, but I want to tell you today that when you talk about being freed from the clutches of low self-esteem and insignificance and a sense of self-worth, non-self-worth, it's amazing how God has brought you out. He selectively delivered you and snatched you out of the jaws of insecurity. In many cases, he lifted you out of the prison of fear. You should always keep in mind that God is a selective savior. And he has delivered us in many cases when we didn't even imagine he could. This is what the psalm emphasizes today. From the very beginning, we are made aware of the negative prospects. Yes, the negative prospects which face God's children. Psalm says here, we would have been swallowed up. We would have been eaten alive. We would have been trapped and troubled and overwhelmed. But the Bible says they found their help in calling on God. Aren't you glad you've got a God that you can call on? You know, I'm reminded of the story about eight people who were trapped on an elevator on the Empire State Building. Of the 102 floors, they got stuck on the 71st floor. The immediate reaction of most of them was panic. Most of you can relate to that. Whenever we're in a situation that looks like we're in between a rock and a hard place, generally the first emotional response is panic. That their immediate reaction was the same way. Some were screaming. Others were crying. Others were just shouting for help. One man was banging on the door and another man was curled up in a ball and it started to convulse. But there was one man on that elevator who was calm and content. He moved with accuracy and confidence. He moved the man that was on the floor aside just a little bit, opened up a panel door within the elevator, found a phone down inside, picked it up and waited. Within less than a minute, someone responded and said, "Is there a problem?" The man that was on the phone said, "We're trapped on the 71st floor." The response was, "We'll be right there with some help immediately." You see, church, he knew who to call, and he knew how to call. And that's how this psalm begins when we talk about the answer to our past. Isn't it a joy to know that when you got in trouble, you knew who to call, and you knew how to call him? I mean, how many of you at some point in your life have faced moments of desperation and found yourself making that call? I love the old song we used to sing years ago that says, "Jesus is on the main line. You can tell him what you want. If you need your body healed, you can tell him what you want. If you need your bills paid, you can tell him what you want. If you're looking at trouble on every side, you can tell him what you want, because Jesus is right there to meet you at the point of your need." The psalmist begins by telling us that the answer to our past is the fact that the Lord is on our side. Paul says in Romans that if God be for us, then who can be against us? I want you to know watching today that God is for you. No matter how much the circumstances try to tell you or indicate to you that you're out here by yourself. Friend, you're not fighting alone. You're not wrestling by yourself. God is for you. And just look back in yesterday. Press rewind and see that the God of the past is right there for you even today. So the psalmist begins by telling us he is our answer to the past. But then secondly, you'll find that he is our solution for the present. He is our solution for the present. The psalm teaches us in verse number 7, he tells us that the snare is broken and freedom is available. And then he identifies his Savior by saying, blessed be the Lord. I want you to see, not only is he a selective Savior, he is a specific Savior. For the snares have been broken. In other words, the traps that had hemmed you in, the bondages that had held you under, the prisons that had restricted your movement and your mobility, it's been broken off your life. Look at the emphasis placed on the deliverer here. Tells us that these snares have been broken and the enemy's power has been vanquished. You know what? I must admit, the reason this scripture was so important to me is because I discovered that I have been reading this wrong for years. I mean, think about the way we quote this. I mean, it doesn't say if it had not been for the Lord who was on our side. No. Rather, it says, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side. There's a marked distinction there. If it had not been for the Lord who was on our side. Yes, that's true. Because that shows us that he's with us. But when it says, if it had not been the Lord who was on our side. That's even more significant because it shows us specifically that we have a God that is here to fight our battles. And I believe David is there thinking of a God and his people and the enormous difference it has made that God is with them. This is a wonderful praise statement of God's protection when they had faced grave danger. I mean, I want you to consider all the dangers and distresses that God's people had faced. They had went through the howling wilderness of the desert. They had to face enemies that they had no protection from. They had to live in bondage for centuries and face the subjugation of a Pharaoh leader. And yet, through all of the things that they faced, God brought them out each and every time. Oh, yeah, friend, I'm telling you today that when you think about this God and our ultimate help, we need a specific redeemer. I don't just need a God that sits high and looks low. I also need a God that sits high and looks low, and he's there to answer my prayer. He's there to collect every tear that I cry. He's there to mend up my broken heart. He's there to bind up all of the wounds. I need someone that has the ability to change my entire life situation. And I stop by to tell you this morning, Galilee, that that's the kind of Savior that we have. We need a Savior that can possess unlimited authority. We have been blessed to have a Lord and a God and a King and a ruler and a master that loves us so much there's no situation he's not willing to get us out of. I mean, think about it now. He controls the weather. He controls the waters. He controls the winds. He controls the rains. He controls the climates. He controls the atmospheres. He controls the storms. He controls the seasons. He controls the devil. He controls your enemies. He controls the darkness. There's nothing that's not under his control. And guess what? That Savior is specifically on your case. He sees you and knows what you're dealing with. You need a specific redeemer. With unlimited power. Make no mistake about it, friend. Everyone can help you when you're in distress. Well, many of you readily admit that some of the problems you have right now, some of the bitterness that you carry right now, Some of the resentment that has come down in your spirit today is a result of recognizing that everybody will not and cannot help you in your distress. I mean, everybody doesn't possess the resources that you need. And no one else can fully understand the impact that fear and turmoil can have on your life. This is one of the hardest lessons that I've had to learn in life. It is that you cannot completely trust people. They will disappoint you. Oh, it may not be malicious. It might not be intentional. But trust me, people in their finite, human, and fragile state will let you down. I mean, if you think I'm wrong, just ask Jesus. He suffered abandonment by his disciples, betrayal by those that he loved, and those that were closest to him in his hour of need, they walked out on him. But aren't you glad to know that you serve a God that sticks closer than any brother? Aren't you glad to know that you serve a God that will always be present in your time of trouble? Aren't you glad to know that this God knows you just as you are? And you don't have to do things to impress him. He loves you no matter what you face. His mercy is made plain for you, and his grace is good for you in any season of your struggle. Boy, it's a joy to know that we have a God that is not only our help in times past, but he is our present Redeemer. He's the answer to our present dilemma. I'm saying this because perhaps as I minister this word today, some of you have been overwhelmed emotionally. Some of you have been overrun financially. Some of you are at a place where you feel overthrown by your feelings and your thoughts and your circumstances. Friend, I want you to know that God is still right there. He is still your refuge and your strength. He is a very present help in the time of trouble. Psalm lets us know that he is our answer to the present. But finally, this psalm tells us that he is our answer to the future. He is our answer to the future. Where do we go from here? How do we get there? Who maps out our course? Who charts our course and navigates our pathway? How do we get there? David is showing us where our reliance ought to be placed. Friend, our reliance, our trust, and our confidence should be in the Lord, for he is our help. When he says the name of the Lord, of course, that is a way of referring to the Lord himself. But the very phraseology, the name of the Lord, reminds us of some very significant and precious truths. Remember when Moses was dealing with God in the backside of the wilderness? And in the desert, when Moses said, Lord, who shall I say you are? What is your name? He said, I am that. I am. Whatever you need me to become, I will become that. And as he moves on further and he evolves into the economy of the Jewish followers that were going through that barren wasteland, he lets them know, I am Jehovah Jireh. I am Jehovah Nissi. I am Jehovah Jah. I am Jehovah Roi. I am Jehovah Zidkenu. I am Jehovah Mkadesh. Everything that you need me to be, I will be that. And I stop by to tell you today that that's what God wants you to know. I will become what you need me to become. I've revealed myself to you by virtue of my deliverance in your life. But I want you to know I'm more than just this nebulous power out in the sky. I want you to recognize I'm more than this generic power that you can feel but you cannot touch. I want you to know I'm not just a general God. I am a specific God. I know you by name. I recognize your down settings and your uprisings. I know your thoughts afar off. He's told us what his name is so that when we face our troubles, we can call on his name. But we don't need to consult a shaman. We don't need to go to a tea leaf reader. We don't need to go and pursue Miss Rudolph. We don't need to ask somebody about what the future's going to look like. All we've got to do is continue to trust in the Lord. He's already let us know he is the true and the living God. And because he has revealed to us who he is, we can count on his kindness. We can depend on his mercy. We can rest in his goodness. We can draw near to him, for he said if we'll draw near to him, he'll draw near to us. Oh yeah, friend, he said, when you need me, all you got to do is call me. It matters who's on your side, friend, in the time of trouble. And I came to tell you today that when you look back over your life, don't just look at one thing specifically that he brought you out of last week or last month. Look at the many deliverances that he's given to you. See, brothers and sisters, we've all been delivered, but not all from the same thing and not all the same way. But Jesus lets us know that I'm big enough and broad enough and rough enough and tough enough and has stuff enough that I can deliver you from whatever you need. And that's the thing I love about him the most. I love the fact that when he enters into your life, he makes your life become more than what it was. He makes your life more and not less. In other words, he's a father to the fatherless. He's a mother to the motherless. He's a friend to the friendless. He's a hope to the hopeless. He's a comfort to the comfortless. He is usage to the useless. He's a lover to the loverless. And I want you to know today, friend, that he is our ultimate help. That's why the Bible lets us know, I will lift up mine eyes to the hills. From whence cometh my help? It doesn't come from the mountain. It doesn't come from the plain. It doesn't come from the rivers. It doesn't come from the seas. But my help comes from the Lord, which made heaven and earth. God bless you, Galilee. God bless you, Dr. McGriff. God bless you, Sister Monica. God bless each and every one of you. And I pray that as you see 20 more wonderful years, that you'll remember who your ultimate help is. No matter how dark the day, he has reassured us that he is our help in times past. He's our help in the present. And he's our help in the future. Let me extend to you, those of you who may be watching today and have not embraced this Lord, you haven't given your life to this Savior. You know, the Bible tells us that whosoever calls upon the name of the Lord shall be saved. How shall we call upon him in whom we've not believed? And how shall we believe in him whom we've not heard? How shall they hear without a preacher? How shall he preach except he be sent? I'm telling you today that all you have to do is pray with repentance and contrition. Lord Jesus, I'm empty. I'm lacking. I'm wanting. I need something more. Come into my life, Lord Jesus. Make me clean. Come into my heart and make me whole. I believe that you died for my sins, that you were buried, and on the third day, you arose with all power in your hands. Put that power in me. Start to navigate my pathway. Even as you allowed these Jewish pilgrims to ascend into your presence and holiness, allow me to ascend into your purpose and your favor. I'll tell others about you. I'll tell others your truth. I'll share with them this marvelous act of salvation. Friend, if you prayed that prayer with me today, you're already on your road to recovery. Just get with a Bible teaching, Bible preaching, Bible believing church, and watch God turn your life to a life of joy and peace. Father, we thank you today for your word and the people that have given their lives to you right now, to the leadership of this wonderful church and to the entire family of the Galilee Baptist Church. We pray that, Lord, you may give them blessing upon blessing. miracle upon miracle and victory upon victory. In Jesus' name, amen and amen. We love you guys. God bless.
To declare it, God's gonna get the glory out of this situation.